tenga bien sembrada. Desde Malanga morada, ñame plátano y yautía. Es porque al salir el día seguida cojo el arado. Ya el terreno preparado, señores, yo lo cultivo. Así de feliz yo vivo mejor que un adinerado.
La antiquísima poesía llamada décima.
Décima poetry is ancient, but it was revived and perfected in the 17th century by the Spanish poet and guitarist from Andalusia, Vicente Martínez de Espinel. His new décima was called the Espinel décima or Espinela. The Espinela was brought to Puerto Rico and to the other Spanish-speaking countries of the Americas by Spanish sailors, soldiers, and emigrants. There, it was preserved among the oral tradition in distinctive ways, unique to each country in which it became popular.
En algunos países, la décima se declama.
In some countries, the décima is just recited. In others, it is recited and sung. In other countries, the décima is recited, sung, and improvised. This is how it is in Puerto Rico.
Los Cubans express their décimas by singing them in their puntos guajiros.
Argentinians, Uruguayans, and Paraguayans sing them in their payadas.
El payador nunca afloja, es el cantor de la gente. Tu pago de San Vicente se quiere abrazar con rojas. Una cosa.
And Panamanians sing their décimas in torrentes. Mexicans also do it in their sones jarochos.
El camino fue cortito, caminaron media cuadra. La vieja ladra que ladra no paraba con sus gritos. Te juro por Dios bendito que no voy a regresar. Aquí me voy a quedar en la casa de mi padre. Tú ves si chingas a tu madre, no me vuelves a tocar.
Feliz el año nuevo.
The décima tradition among the Puerto Rican jíbaro and the troubadour's song can be traced back from an ancient past up to the present day. Originally in Puerto Rico, the décima was crudely composed, not faithfully following the rules as Espinel had established them. But over the centuries, Puerto Rican troubadours perfected it, and expert jíbaro troubadours were required to memorize the many, many traditional rules of the décima and apply them to their passionate jíbaro song. What are these rules?
Se llamaba décima porque se compone 10 versos, octosílabos, que tienen que rimar en rima consonante.
It's called a décima because it's made up of 10 lines or verses that are octosyllabic, that must rhyme in a specific way. The first line must rhyme with the fourth and fifth lines. The second line must rhyme with the third line. The sixth line must rhyme with the seventh and tenth lines. And the eighth line must rhyme with the ninth. But what do we mean by octosyllabic? It's because the syllables in each line usually add up to 8.
Espinel.
muchas ocasiones al trovador.
In many instances, the troubadour is given a theme or phrase that he must improvise upon. The troubadour must then actually conclude each décima with the given phrase. This practice is known as the pie forzado, or forced foot. Let's hear now the troubadour Víctor Manuel Reyes improvising a décima that ends or is footed with the phrase suggested to him by someone in the audience. It is not a simple thing to be singing a verse while at the same time thinking up the next one that must follow.
Décima completa se compone de cuatro estrofas.
A complete décima is made up of four parts, each part a 10-line poem. But that's not all. But it's considered a syllable, and how the syllables in a line are counted follow these other rules. In the Spanish language, words that are pronounced most forcefully on the last syllable are called agudas, or acute words. If a verse ends in an acute word, a syllable is added to the syllable count. If the most forcefully pronounced syllable is the one before the last syllable, the word is allana, or flat word. If the line ends with a flat word, the syllable count is not altered. If the most forcefully pronounced syllable is the second from the last syllable, it is known as an esdrújula. So if the line ends with an esdrújula word, one syllable is subtracted from the syllable count. Verses ending in esdrújula words are not very common. But listen to the great decimista troubadour Germán Rosario singing a funny nonsense décima composed entirely of verses ending in esdrújula words.
Un magnate aristocrático trató una niña de zángana, dando lugar a una tángana entre un grupo burocrático. Era un sujeto antipático, según dicen los versátiles, que se mantenía con dátiles, cosechadas en Cantábrica, en donde tenía una fábrica de maquinaria portátil.
And so that's what the décima was, and how it continues to be to this day, an ancient, persistent, and versatile expression of our people.
Yo no me puedo ir de aquí si no le dedico una décima al caballero que está grabando. Necesito saber tu nombre.
William.
William. Y William con mi estandarte. en Navidad.